What's up, you guys? 47 Golf. We are at FXE, Fort Lauderdale Executive. We're getting ready to go to Opa-locka. Look what we got. Clear skies today. No visit from thunderstorms on this flight. You see it. Ready? Y'all ready to go flying? Let's go flying. Let's go have some fun, all right?
When you leave out of Fort Lauderdale Executive Airports, there are many ways you can transition Fort Lauderdale International's airspace. You can either go out west, where you avoid the airspace altogether, or you can go all the way out over the shoreline, where they request that you go at 500 feet or below, or you can go over the top, which is what I chose to do today. 2,500 feet to transition Fort Lauderdale Airport airspace. You also have two options when you're leaving as well. You can get flight following, or just contact Fort Lauderdale Tower immediately after leaving Executive. I find that flight following is a little bit more easier. Transitioning Fort Lauderdale International Airport over the shoreline at 500 feet or below is the more fun, more popular route that most local pilots take. But I was in a rush today, and going over the top would have gotten me to Opa-locka quicker. As usual, Opa-locka was very busy, and for spacing, they asked me to do a 360. If you look closely, you'll see the Gulfstream landing at the end of the runway. I was number two landing after him. The spacing was needed to give him time to land and avoid his wake turbulence. I got a great surprise when I landed. I heard our other airplane, 465, taxiing out, and I recognized the voice. It was Heather.
Yes, 64465. We have information Lima. We were like, we're ready to taxi to the active, but well, what's on the buses?
November 465, runway 9 or left, taxi the Papa, November 6, November.
Taxi the Papa, November 6, November. Runway 9 or left for 64465.
November 47 Golf continues in traffic at 12 o'clock. Just westbound on Papa's going to use November 6 of Cessna 172.
And as I responded to ground control, Heather recognized my voice and...
Hi, Ben.
That was pretty cool. I felt like Steve-O-1 Knievo getting a shout out over the radio. I have been flying 465 a lot lately, so it was weird seeing it go without me. But I felt good that Heather was flying it.